Shalom, royal family. The class you are about to hear is taught by the Honorable Yahweh, Beit Nunsilfi Yahweh, many years ago. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Visit us at www.yahweh144000.com. Also, royal family, you can enroll in classes designed for the Godhead at www.universityofyahweh.org. Enjoy.
Let's go into faithful. As a mirror, you must be faithful. I'm that faithful witness in Revelation.
Faithful, strict or thorough in the performance of duty. True to one's word, promises, vows, etc.
Now look at this. You can't be in the family of God, Yahweh, and not keep your vows. To be in the brotherhood of God, Yahweh, you must keep your word. You have to be true to your word. A vow has to mean something to you.
Vow, a solemn promise or earnest pledge, especially to live or act in a specified way. Vow, a solemn promise, pledge, commitment, or assertion. One by which a person is bound to an act, service, or condition. Vow, pledge, promise, assurance, word of honor, oath. Vow, sworn statement or declaration. Vow, engagement, marriage contract, marriage bond, agreement, contract, vow.
And how would you look not being a part of the brotherhood family of God? To be a brother in the family of Yahweh, look what it requires you to be. A faithful representation. One who is strict on himself. You don't need someone else to be strict on you. You're strict on yourself. You hold yourself in bounds. You look and you see what is out of the bounds of Yahweh, and you say, that's out of the bounds of my Father. I'm not stepping out there. Drugs out there, I'm not stepping out the bounds. There's no drugs in the circle of the brotherhood of Yahweh. No drugs in here. There's drugs out there, so I'm going to hold myself in here. I'm not stepping out there where the alcoholics are. I'm not stepping outside the bounds where the liars are, deceivers and the tricksters. I'm not going out there. I'm going to be strict on myself, hold myself in bounds, because I made a vow. I made a vow to the Lord, Yahweh, and I won't take it back. I won't take it back. Some people make a vow and they go back. But I won't take it back. This is what seeing means. That requires a new song, does it not? Going to study and learn about this name. And how to sing praises to this name, Yahweh. The name Yahweh is a name that was hidden from us. The name of our great, good, and terrible Creator, Yahweh, has raised me up to save you, deliver you, redeem you, reform you, make you a new people. into Yahweh's own nation. That's my purpose. And that I'm accomplishing. Some might have counted Yahweh be both great, good, and terrible at the same time. That may sound dichotomous, but it only proves that he is all in all. Anyone who tells you that God is all good and doesn't do anything that you may consider bad, doesn't know God. Yahweh creates darkness, and Yahweh creates light. Yahweh creates good, peace, and Yahweh, the creator of the universe, creates evil. I, the Lord Yahweh, do all these things. I do good and I do evil. What kind of God is that? The one who made positive and negative. The one who made gravity and anti-gravity. That's who he is. He's the one that makes a lie. Yahweh is also the one that kills. What kind of God is that? Just what he is. Killer. And he's a life giver. If you don't know that about God, I don't know where you live. Because life and death are all around us. He brings us sunshine, rain, but with the rain also comes flood. With the sun also comes heat waves and death from the heat waves. With the rain sometimes come hurricanes and tornadoes, which brings death and destruction. And my book tells me that Yahweh, the Creator, has his way in the sun. Now let's read. I'm getting too far ahead. Let's go back and read some of it. The first one was to create darkness, to create good and evil.
Isaiah 45:7.
And make sure you understand that the Bible that you were never taught is saying what I said. Because you were not taught doesn't mean it's not here. The reason we are successful is because of this name. Isaiah 45:5. I am the Lord Yahweh, and there is none else. There is no God beside me. I am the only God you're ever going to see. You will never see another one, because there is not another one beside me. You may say, how is that? It's only because you have not known me. Though I girded you, protected you, brought you from birth to your present state, I girded you and watched over you to bring you to a position where you can doubt. Yes, I girded you, though you doubt me. Why? Because you have not known me. But I'm doing a work that all may know from the rising of the sun, that's in the east. All the people in the east, I don't care what their religion is. You live in the east, I don't care what your eastern religion is. You're gonna know, just like everybody from the west, that there is none beside me. I am the Lord Yahweh, and there is none else. And if you don't believe that, you don't believe what you just read. Let me tell you a little bit more about myself. I form the light. Without me, there is no life. And I create darkness. Whenever you see peace, I'm the one that makes peace. And I create evil. I, the Lord Yahweh, do all these things. And what makes me so powerful is it doesn't matter whether you like it or don't like it, I do it anyway. That's what makes me God. Because I do what I want to. And you can't do anything about it. Then I said, I kill and I make a lot.
Deuteronomy 32, 39.
See now. Let your mind perceive and understand right now that I, even I, am He. And there is no God with me. Yes, I kill. And you ought to be glad that I also make a lie. You ever been wounded? I wound you. I wound everything that's wounded. I wound bugs and cats and dogs. Meow, I tell them. Now here I am also here. Neither is there anybody, anything that can deliver out of my hand. Deal with it. You have to deal with me. Yahweh, that's my name. That's the prophecy. Yahweh. And this name has been hidden from the so-called black man of America 434 years. Now, I know all about what you've been taught, so don't sit in your seats and wonder and think, I don't know what you've been taught. I know all about it. The name is Yahweh. No other name. In this name is life. This name is life itself. Eternity is in this name. In fact, if you receive this name and believe in this name, you will live forever. Anybody ever wanted to live forever? You're going to live one place or the other forever. It doesn't matter. See how powerful Yahweh is? It doesn't matter whether you want to live forever or don't want to live forever. You're going to live someplace forever. Hell or heaven. People don't like to hear that. You go to church, you can't hear that no more. Everybody talks about heaven. Nobody wants to tell you about hell. I'm here to tell you, you're going to live forever. Anyway, where do you want to live? Is the question. Now, to those who don't love Yahweh, my message is frightening. And to those that love Yahweh, my message is frightening. Yes. To love Yahweh is to fear Yahweh. Where? Proverbs 1:7. Read.
The fear of the Lord Yahweh is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction.
So we have a choice to be wise. And we have a choice tonight to begin to know. And I'm here to encourage you begin to know. And you have to have a little knowledge that Yahweh is all powerful as you read the book and understand it. All powerful. And he's the only one that you can learn about through his name. The character, the characteristics, the attributes of Yahweh are all contained in his name, in the name Yahweh. The name Yahweh is responsible for all that you see. All the wealth that you see us have, it's all from the name. I have many men who come to see me these days who are in leadership positions, and they say things like, "You're a genius, he's a genius." They make a mistake when they say that. I'm not a genius. I am the genius. Egotistical. That's because I'm an egoist. I'm ego, super ego, super ego. And I'm here to make you something you never thought you could be. God. And many of you ever wanted to be a God? Let me see the hand. Tell the truth, don't be sitting up in here lying. No telling what y'all would do to you for lying. How many have wanted to be a God? Praise God. See, if you've never wanted to be a God, that's why you're on the bottom of civilization now. That's why you have a job instead of create a job. God create jobs. You never wanted to be a God, then it means you've always wanted somebody to rule over you. The only reason we've never wanted to be gods is that no one ever taught us we should want to be. No one ever taught us that we could be. No one ever told us that we really are the children of God. How can you say in church on Sunday, "I'm a child of God," and don't realize that makes you a little God? How are you going to be detached from God and yet say you're a child of God? A child of God means you're a little God. So if you don't want to be a God like your Father, who is the supreme God, then you're saying, "I don't want nothing to do with my Father." I raised a legitimate question when I said, "How many of you want to be God?" But somebody has to tell you that you're God. I didn't say that you made the sun. I did that. I made the sun, moon, and stars. You didn't. I did. I made all of that. I made the air you breathe, the water you drink, food you eat. I gave you life, everything. I put the support system in before I brought you here. But you're my children. You're my sons and my daughters. You have the potential to be perfect just like me. See, nobody told you that before. I'm perfect. And you can be perfect too. In fact, you ought to be perfect. Well, I don't want to get too far ahead of you. Let's go back to Psalm 82, 6. Lest you think something strange. In verse 1, Psalm 82, verse 1, Yahweh stands in the congregation of the mighty and judges among the gods, proving there's more than one God. Yahweh judges among the gods. Now look at verse 6. Psalms chapter 82, verse 6. I have said, you are God. Read it. And all of you are children of the Most High. Yeah. Now, when I first said that to you, you looked at me real strange. Now you really have to look strange because it's in the Bible. It was always in the Bible. When I said it, it was in the Bible. What shocking is, I know it and you don't. So when I say it, it shocks your system. It blows your mind. This man up there talking about, I'm a God, man. Nobody ever told me I'm no God. Right. That's why you've never been one. I also said you were supposed to be perfect.
Matthew 5:48.
Well, let's turn. Matthew chapter 5. Hey, oh, that's an Old Testament. No, this is the New Testament. Matthew chapter 5. New Testament. I love the word. It's just fun. Read that, somebody. Y'all read that for me.
Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father, Yahweh, which is in heaven, is perfect.
Why have you never tried to be perfect before?
We told nobody can be perfect.
No one ever taught us that we should. When I read this and asked all the preachers and bishops that I ever met in my life, they denied the Son of God saying this by telling me the Spirit is strong. You know the rest of it, because you heard it. But, let's see, you know. You learned that right away. So you never tried to make your flesh strong. Because your preacher had told you your flesh is weak. Yet the Son of God has to tell you, be perfect. I could not be the Son of Yahweh and tell you, you don't have to be perfect. The Son of Yahweh must tell you these words. Don't try. No. I will not accept you trying to be perfect. Right now, quit being imperfect. Be God now. Isn't that exciting? Coming here is exciting. Now, the only reason that I have to tell you to be perfect is because you've been living imperfect. Now give me imperfect, darling. The name Yahweh makes you perfect. When you receive the name, believe in the name, then you can live perfect. You can be perfect. No reason not to be. You have every reason to be. I've proven to you tonight that you are God and you are children of the Most High. So what happens to your mind? Your mind is going to have to come from most low to a state of most high. How are our people trained to think in the world? Most low. Go out in the street. No, you've been in the street. You don't have to go out there. You come from the street. The thoughts in the street are how? Most low. What is the vocabulary of the street? Profane. One profane word after another. It sounds like everybody's vocabulary is just one big, long profanity. I mean, they're out there talking about everybody's mother. And talk about you with somebody's mother. About what you're doing to somebody's mother. I know you hear it because I've heard it. Imperfect.
imperfect, of, pertaining to, or characterized by defects.
Defect. This means that our minds are defective. And I'm telling you, you must stop being defective. Go ahead.
Not perfect.
Mm-hmm.
Lacking completeness.
Lacking. You are lacking something. There's something wrong with the black man's mind. You say, what's wrong with black folk? Well, that's the answer right here in the Bible. You are without knowledge. You're incomplete. What are you lacking? The name Yahweh. This name will straighten you right out. With this name, you can be God. With this name, you can be perfect. With this name, your defects will disappear. With the name Yahweh, you will become complete. You don't only lack incompleteness, means you lack money. You don't have enough of it. How many have enough money? Don't have enough money, then you are lacking in money. Your life is incomplete. And I think you lack some of everything. Literally defective. We're not only functionally literate, but mentally defective. Imperfect.
Imperfect. Designating a tense or other verb formation, noting incompleted action or state, especially with reference to the past.
Now, we sure are messed up when it comes to the past. We have forgotten the name of our Father. That's about as incomplete as you can get it. That's why when we win football games during the halftime, the brothers come out with a weight 400 pounds, knock down 50 men on the field.
Hi, man.
Have you ever noticed these bruisers never say, hi, Dad. Hi, Father. Hi, Papa. It's always Mama Mia. We've forgotten the name of our Father. Some of us never knew it. Very incomplete. I'm here to introduce you to your Father. At least his name. He lives in his name. Your Father, your true Father, lives in his name. And when you believe in his name and receive his name, he begins to live inside you and erase your defective thinking and makes you complete. And then you be reconnected with your past, which begins from Genesis and before Genesis through Revelation, because this Bible is your history. You, the black people of America, are the people of the Bible. You are the subject. And knowledge of the name Yahweh will make you complete. Come on, baby, give me some more incomplete.
Imperfect. Being without legal effect.
Being without legal effect. That's why you need voting rights here. You notice that everybody who comes to America, they don't need voting rights here. They have a legal effect. We're the only people in America that need civil rights here. They don't treat us civilly. As long as you're black. You dress like me, you get treated civilly. I'm treated civilly. I don't need no bill. I don't need a bill. You may need a bill, but I don't. No other nation, no other people can make me free. I'm born free. They cannot enslave my mind. I don't care, 100 crackers might can take my body somewhere, but they sure can't take my mind anyway. I'm born free. No man can give me freedom. Free people don't march on Washington. I make Washington. I tear down Washington. I do what I want to Washington or with Washington. That's my power. The only reason that you don't feel power is you are disconnected to your past. You're disconnected from your father, Yahweh. That's the only reason you feel without power. You feel like you need help. I don't need a man to give me a job. I create jobs. I'm a man. And it works for my feet just like it will any other man's feet. I can plant an apple tree and it will become an apple tree for me just like it will any other man on earth. I can tell what I need from anybody else when Yahweh is the creator of all life. You know what I need. Why am I talking like this? Because you are God. You are children of the Most High Yahweh. You are to be perfect in your mind. Your thinking and your thoughts are to be perfect, not imperfect. You are to be perfectly connected. When you can reconnect with your Father Yahweh, then your mind is elevated to perfection. Your mind becomes complete. And it's a wonderful feeling. I'm a witness. Does that give us an idea about what this scripture is telling us we ought to be? Why are we told to be perfect? Because our minds are not perfect. Be perfect. The name is perfect. Perfect. The name Yahweh is perfect. Receive the name, Yahweh. It is perfect. Read.
Perfect, conforming absolutely to the description or definition of the type.
Right. Who is the type? Yahweh is the type. Conforming absolutely. Being perfect requires absolute conformity. See, a lot of people don't want to conform. And they take pride in calling themselves non-conformists. See, I am an individual. And I am truly a non-conformist. Nobody is going to tell me what to do. Wait till the SWAT team breaks in your house. In the meantime, being perfect requires absolute conformity to the name Yahweh, which is the type. Isn't that incredible? So whatever Yahweh is about, that's what you and I ought to be about.
Royal family and friends, thank you for listening. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Also, please visit us at www.yahweh144000.com. And also, you can enroll in the University of Yahweh by visiting us at www.universityofyahweh.org. Royal family and friends, have a glorious day. In Yud Hey Wav Hey. Shalom, Royal Family.